Friends, welcome to this class. I'm your Karthik Ravan Karte and this is Karte Tutorials, right? So in this video we are going to discuss about this photochemistry, right? So what is this photochemistry? The definition I have written on the board, right? So it is the study of chemical processes when the molecule is subjected to irradiation. What kind of irradiation? We irradiate light of wavelength around 200 nanometer to 800 nanometer. You can tell, you know that 200 to 400 is nothing but EV region, right? EV radiation we apply, and also from 400 to 800 it is our visible light. So most of the phenomena which we have studied in EV visible spectroscopy are applicable to photochemistry, as it involves the irradiation from 200 to 800 nanometer, right? So EV to visible region, it is there. So most of the phenomena will be same, right? So only few things will be different here and there that we will discuss in this chapter, right? So this is the definition of photochemistry. Before going further, let us see a few more things. So I have one molecule like this, right? So I will irradiate light, right? H nu, symbol of photochemistry, means photons I am applying, means I will show it by the symbol H nu, right? So I will tell the product BC is formed and A, like this product is formed. You may ask, sir, why not this EB is formed and C? I will tell this is not formed and this is formed. So the problem is, see, in photochemistry reaction we can write products in many possibilities are there, but in books only few products they will give, right? So the reason behind that is, I can explain here only. See, I have told I have this molecule, I will tell only this product is formed, not this product. The reason will be, see, this BC bond will be very strong, so we get this product, we can tell, right? So there are three possibility reason. One is this one, since this bond is strong we will get this product, and this bond is weak, this bond will be broken, right? So one possibility. And the second possibility is the formed product will be minor, that is because it is unstable, we won't get this product but we get this product, right? So with examples in future with these videos you will get it. I will tell the product formed will be unstable, because of that we will get this product major and this product minor or not formed, like that. Other thing is, there may be formation of this product but it will be in minor quantity, very less. So these are the three possibilities. One is the bond of this may be stronger and this will be weaker. Second possibility is the product formed, other product formed will be unstable, so we will get this product major. And the third possibility is this product is formed, no doubt, but it is formed in less quantity or minor quantity, right? So these are the possibilities, right? So whenever we apply this photochemical conditions, you should always remember that it is going to cleave homolytically, right? So it will going to cleave homolytically, so we will get radicals. So if you have studied radical chemistry, then you can able to tell which radical is stable, which radical will react fast, right? So we know that stability of radicals. So carbon radical, if I have, tertiary radical will be more stable than secondary radical, then comes primary radical, right? So oxygen next to which carbon is there, like at CH2, and carbon is having radical. This radical is very stable because oxygen will be lone pair, having lone pair they can stabilize this radical, right? If I have like this compound CH3, oxygen having radical, so this will be highly unstable because oxygen is an electronegative atom, it can't have radical on it, right? It will be highly unstable. So heteroatom like oxygen, nitrogen, this can't have this radical, those will be highly unstable. So stability of radical for carbon I have told tertiary, secondary, primary, because radical, see, radical I can write like this CH and one radical. So why it is radicals are act as intermediates, right? So because, see, if you count the electron, one bond is two electrons, so 2, 4, 6 and one electron, so 7 electron. So you know that to form octet, the molecules which follows octet rule or forms octet will be stable. So octet means 8 electrons should be there, but here they have got one electron less, because of which radicals are intermediate, these are highly reactive, so we call it as intermediate, like carbocation, like similarly these radicals are intermediates and these react very fastly. Their reaction will be very very fast, right? So this is about radicals, right? So I have told heteroatom can't have radical as heteroatom is electronegative, they can't stabilize. But heteroatom is next to the radical, then it will stabilize by its lone pair, right? Because radical, it requires one more electron, so this acts as electron deficient, right? So near electron rich elements are there, they will stabilize. But also in radical chemistry, when we discuss, if there are electron withdrawing group next to the radical, then also that radical will be stabilized, right? That thing we will discuss in radical chemistry, right? So this is the basic thing of radicals. So photochemistry means homolytical cleavage. You should remember this, homolytical cleavage. One more thing, the radical which is more stable, you see, whenever I do homolytical cleavage like this, let us assume that this radical is little stable and this is less stable. I hope you know how to tell stable and less stable. One which is tertiary, if we tell that this is tertiary carbon and tertiary radical it is, so it will be stable because of plus I effect or hyperconjugation effect, you can tell, right? So this is less stable. So one which is less stable will do very fastly the next reaction. So less stable means it is not at all stable, so it will react with other molecule very fastly, right? Whereas this reaction, it will also react because it is also intermediate, but it is stable, so it will react slowly to form product, right? So based on this, we will get two different product. We can tell whether it is major or it is minor, that we will see in the upcoming classes, right? So this is about the introduction to photochemistry, right? And also photochemistry, there is another branch in which radiation chemistry is there. So radiation chemistry is very different from this photochemistry. In radiation chemistry, what happens is that, see, here I have two molecules, let us say, we apply radiation such as photons we apply, or we apply X-rays or gamma rays, very high frequency radiation which are having more energy we apply, so we will get like this. One cation we will get, if carbon is there, we can call cation. Instead of that, I can tell like charges I will get. Positive and negative charge like that. So this radiation chemistry is entirely different from this photochemistry, right? So photochemistry means UV visible radiation we are going to apply, and we are going to get homolytical product, and we are going to get radicals as the intermediates, right? So that thing you should remember. So other thing, next what I should tell. So I have told everything, I think. So let us see one more photochemistry the principles. So principle of photochemistry, right? That we shall see. So principle of photochemistry. What is the principle of photochemistry? So see, in photochemistry, the beautiful thing is, so I have told it is like UV visible spectroscopy only, right? So sigma bond, pi bond, N and pi star will be there, and sigma star, right? UV visible spectroscopy, we have learned these things, right? So whenever we apply photochemistry condition, see, if pi, it acts as homo, right? Let us assume that N is not there in the molecule, means non-bonding electrons are not there. So these are bonding orbitals, two bonding orbitals and two antibonding orbitals. When I apply this photochemical condition, see, from homo this electron jumps to here. So it jumped like this. Initially, see, like this I have. So its spin is ulta. Here also it is ulta only. So it has not changed its spin, right? So this is my sigma pi, this is pi star, and this is sigma star. Star stands for antibonding molecular orbitals. Antibonding molecular orbitals. These are not suitable for bond formation, right? These are having high energy, so not suitable for bond formation. These are bonding molecular orbital. Bonding molecular orbital, suitable for bond formation as it has got low energy, right? So this is a reaction when we apply this photochemical condition. So the reaction, further reaction occurs from this only, right? So what the principle of photochemistry tells is that, so whenever we apply radiation, there will be excitation of electrons. So these excited electrons forms the product. That is nothing but principle of photochemistry, right? So when we apply radiation, there will be excitation of electrons from ground state to excited state. From that excited state, it will react and it will form product. That is the principle, right? So how we can tell the energy of it, right? So I have told you this 200 to 800 nanometer of radiation we apply photochemistry, right? So energy, if we want to calculate for this 200 nanometer, how we calculate energy, we know that E is equal to H mu, right? So it can be also written as HC by lambda. So for molecules, if I have number of moles of substance, then we should multiply it by N. So energy of this mole of substances we'll get as N. You know that Avogadro's number, 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. H, Planck's constant, 6.625 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second, right? So C is nothing but speed of light, and it is given by 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. And I have radiation. So here from 200 nanometer to 800 nanometer I have told. So let us calculate for 200 nanometer. So if I put here 200 nanometer, I need to convert it into SI unit, because all I have taken in SI unit, joule per second, meter per second. So 200 nanometer we can convert it into 10 to the power minus 9 meter, right? Because 1 nanometer is equal to 10 to the power minus 9 meter, right? These things I know. So if I calculate these things, I will get the energy when I apply 200 nanometer of wavelength, right? So for 800 nanometer, just to put everything same, just instead of 200 nanometer, here do 800, right? Then calculate, you will get the energy of the radiation, right? So this is about radiation. So what are all the things we have discussed? We discussed the principle of photochemistry, and also we discussed what is photochemical reactions, and also we discussed about the radiations, right? So let us distinguish between photochemical reactions and thermal reactions. There will be more difficulties, right? So how we can distinguish between them, let us see that. So thermal reaction I have, and one more thing is photochemical reaction. Right. So in your lab you will do the reaction, like, can you tell the name of this? This is acetanilide, right? To this I will do bromination, right? How we will do bromination? We take acetanilide, we will take bromine here what we call it is, right? You know that from drop wise we leave it at 25 degree, that is room temperature, 25 degree Celsius. Slowly we add and we keep on stirring it with the glass rod, so that we will get this product, parabromoacetanilide. So we will get parabromo. See, from this it's para position, ortho, meta, para. This position is ipso, ortho, meta, para. This is ipso, right? So ortho, meta, para. So parabromoacetanilide, we get it. So the reaction is going out at 25 degree Celsius. So if you see in the lab, you will observe that you will take this acetanilide in a conical flask, right? And this bromine in that what we call burette. Slowly we rotate it and we shake it like this, right? So that we will get this parabromoacetanilide, right? So the reaction is going out at room temperature, and also light is there. Whether it is photochemical reaction or thermal reaction, right? So now you will feel, so 25 degree it might be thermal, but I will tell this reaction you will carrying out at open condition, only light is there visible, right? So it can be a photochemical reaction also, right? So but this reaction is thermal reaction. You will ask, how sir, why it is only thermal reaction, light is also there, right? So do one thing, same reaction you carry out in a dark room. Dark means there should not be any light, right? So you cover it everything, and just keep on adding, and then you will get the product. Just take its right. So what you can take, IR you can take, right? UV visible spectroscopy you can take, or NMR you can take. From that you will get the structure. Whether you will get the same, you check it in dark reaction. Dark means everything, there should not be any light. So you carry out in dark reaction, we call, right? Dark reaction means no light. You will get the same product, right? So if, since you get same product, right, in dark reaction, temperature will be room temperature, 25 degree. So this reaction is thermal reaction, not photochemical reaction. Because thermal reaction, photochemical reaction means if we change the temperature, I'll tell one more example. Let me give you, then I'll give you the difference, how we can differentiate between photochemical and thermal reaction. So what is this anisole? CH3O, and it is attached to benzene ring, right? So here if I write like this, it is, you should understand that it is CH3 group is there here, right? We never show that, as we have grown up, we never show CH3, just we, if we show the line, it is understood, right? So this is our anisole. So this, I do nitration, right? Nitration means concentrated HNO3 I will take, not concentrated, a little dilute only I will take, in excess I will take, I will do nitration. So NO2 plus will be the electrophile, but the reaction I will carry out at 0 degree Celsius and I will get this product. NO2 here, OCS3 here, anisole, right? Para nitro anisole we will get, right? So since this reaction is carrying out at 0 degree Celsius, whether it is thermal reaction or photochemical reaction, the answer is this is also thermal reaction. Because I will tell the same thing, you carry out the reaction in dark condition, means you should not apply any light, then also you will see, you will get the same product, right? So this is also a thermal reaction, right? So how to distinguish between photochemical reaction and thermal reaction, right? So one more thing, here we use 25 degree Celsius, here I have used 0 degree Celsius. If the same reaction, if you take the same anisole, instead of 0 degree Celsius, just you go for room temperature or more than 10 degree Celsius, if you go, you will get a char, a dark solution. It is because of multi-nitration happens. Nitration at ortho, para, everywhere the nitration happens, right? So this will be char color, right? So if you get only one substituted nitration also, it will be dark color, dark black color. So this temperature you need to maintain. If I want to ask, when if electron donating group is there, you will keep the temperature less than light, less than 0 degree Celsius or less than room temperature. If electron withdrawing group is there, more than, how you will going to set that thing we should know till now, because these all things you have studied in lab, right? So you should know those things, when we how to maintain the temperature, whether it takes a lower temperature, more temperature, room temperature, everything we should know, right? So let us distinguish between this thermal reaction and photochemical reaction, right? So first thing, thermal reaction depends upon heat, I can call. More heat, it may go, reaction may go fast, less heat, it may go slow, like that. So it is also, it goes on light condition and its intensity. More intense red light, faster will be the reaction. Less intense light, slower will be the reaction, like that. It depends upon light and it depends upon heat, right? If I apply light here, there will be no effect of light in thermal reaction. So no effect, right? You just write along with me, no effect, no effect of light when in thermal reaction. Similarly here, no effect of heat in photochemical reaction, right? And one interesting thing, this is very important, see, which I have told here, right? So I have like this electron, right? So to this, if I add thermal condition, then what happens? See, just you see, here two electron, two electron. In thermal condition, I'll get same thing here like this. No change here. Whereas to same this, just add photochemical condition, right? To same this thing, just add photochemical reaction, I'll get this thing. So from this HOMO, there will be excitation like this. Now there is no change in spin, but during reaction there will be change in spin, that I will discuss in the upcoming videos, right? No need to worry. So there is When we apply the radiation, photochemical radiation, there is excitation of electron from HOMO to LUMO. Then from this it will react and it will form product. That we discussed in principle of photochemistry reaction, right? So this is the main difference. In thermal reaction, there is no excitation of electron. So no excitation. But here in photochemical condition, there is excitation of electron. That is the difference. Because of this different, we get a different product, right? So here the product formed will be from excited state, it will react and it will form the product, right? So this product, and here the reaction is from this only, HOMO only, but here no excitation happens, but here it will react like this only, it will form product, because of which the two products formed from thermal reaction and the product formed from photochemical reaction will be different. So this is the main point which I wanted to tell, right? I hope I have covered everything here. So here the reaction happens from HOMO, right? Whereas in the photochemical reaction, the reaction happens from LUMO. I think you know about HOMO and LUMO. Otherwise, let me tell you. So I drew like the sigma, pi, pi star, and this is sigma star, right? So here I told like this, right? So these bonds are there, right? These are bonding molecular orbital suitable for bond formation, and these are anti-bonding molecular orbital. So bonding molecular orbital is there, right? One which is highest energy in bonding. There are two bonding molecular orbitals, this one and this one, sigma and pi. One which is having highest energy of bonding molecular energy is called as HOMO. So HOMO means here highest occupied molecular orbital. Both, all four are molecular orbitals, right? Molecular orbital. How molecular orbitals are formed? If I have two atomic orbitals, both will combine to form two molecular orbitals like this. One will be bonding molecular orbital, one will be antibonding molecular orbital. Similarly, here four atomic orbitals combined to form four bonding molecular orbitals. Sorry, four molecular orbitals, in which two are bonding molecular orbitals and two are antibonding molecular orbitals. Within that bonding molecular orbital, one which is having higher energy. Higher energy, we always show this scale based on energy. Right, energy, sigma will be having low energy, then comes pi, then comes pi star, last comes sigma star. This is energy level. So one which is having higher energy level within bonding molecular orbital, we call it as HOMO. HOMO stands for highest occupied molecular orbital. Occupied means here, it's here. Two electrons here also there, here also there. But here it is occupied and having highest energy, so we call it as HOMO. And with this antibonding, within this, one which is having lower energy, we call it as LUMO. LUMO stands for CF. LUMO. Lowest unoccupied molecular orbital. Right. So lowest means it will be having lowest in energy. So it is unoccupied. See, here it is empty. So lowest unoccupied molecular orbital. Because all four are molecular orbitals. Right. I have explained it. Right. So this is when you will study all the things in inorganic chemistry also, right? Molecular orbital theory, there you will study. If two atomic orbitals combine, A and B, they will form two molecular orbitals. One will be bonding molecular orbital, one will be antibonding molecular orbital. Bonding molecular orbital will be having lower energy, antibonding will be having higher energy. So bonding molecular orbitals are the responsible for bond formation, and antibonding molecular orbitals are responsible for the bond breaking. They won't form bond, right? So as they have higher energy, right? So these were the simple things. So photochemical reaction, thermal reaction, how to distinguish, I have told. And also you can see, we can distinguish the product, because in photochemical reaction, there will be excitation from LUMO to, HOMO to LUMO. From LUMO, the reaction happens. So we will get different product. Whereas in thermal reaction, from HOMO only reaction happens, not from LUMO, because there is no excitation of electrons, right? So here excitation of electrons happens because of the irradiation of light, right? So what kind of light we irradiate? From 200 to 800 nanometer we irradiate, and also we have calculated how much energy it will corresponding to that nanometer, right? And the other thing is, we have discussed about the principles of photochemistry. In next class, let us see a few more concepts.